so I need to put it to sleep. Okay, use the stomp. Huh?
I love you. I want to hear you say that you don't love me.
I don't love you.
Well, there's nothing to do. We keep falling flat on our face in this run. Honestly, it's kind of disheartening. But that doesn't mean we give up. If you keep falling over, you get back up. Talk shit, you get hit, as they say. Wish I had a good Pokemon. Wish I didn't have to use Chikorita.
Good morning. My life is an inescapable hell. If you clicked on this video, I'll assume you already know what a Nuzlocke is. So let me just get you up to speed on the rules that I'm using. Of course, there's the basics, but I'm also playing with no items, I'm playing on set mode, and level caps that correspond with each to make this as hardcore as possible. But there's one more. Whiting out does not mean game over. I only lose if I don't have any remaining Pokemon in my party or my PC. This makes it so that, if I mess up and die, I get to be creative and try and learn from my mistakes, which I think makes for a better streaming experience. It's more fun for me, and it's more fun for you. Also, I lost to Bugsy twice on stream, and I do not want to do that again.
Bruh.
So, where did I go wrong? Well, you see, Whitney's cow is what I would call intensely aggravating. It has an insane stat spread for this point in the game, and with access to Stomp and Attract to impede your movement, Milk Drink for healing, and Rollout for damage, one string of bad luck means your fight is over. Even my master planning.
This is kind of what drowsy looks like, right?
Master planning was completely worthless in the face of bad luck and the fact that I forgot that she had Scrappy. It also didn't help that I had two flying types just begging to die. And I forgot you could trade drowsy from a choke in the department store. I also lost my best Miltank counter, Geodude.
He's still faster? Oh shit!
To an unfortunate miscalculation about how many rock polishes I had used. But it's okay. We can't do anything about it now, we just have to roll with the punches and learn from our mistakes. So where do we go from here? Well, isn't it obvious? I already said we're not out till we have no remaining Pokemon in our PC. So we just gotta dig through our PC box and see what scraps we got lying around, and make a winning team out of them.
Alright, there's no reason to worry. I don't need good Pokemon. I don't even need to be good at Pokemon to beat this challenge. All I need is some patience, persistence, and a little bit of creativity. Let's see who I have left. Ew.
Well, this is it. These are my options. What happened here? Did I go on a drunken tirade and kill all my Pokemon? Oh wait, no. They all died on stream. But it's like I always say, when you're riding down the Mississippi Ferry, sometimes you need that purple cherry. Let's look at our options. Here we have an unknown with hidden power, Dragon. I left this little guy in the daycare for too long, and now he's old enough to drink, which means I can't bring him along to this fight. Well, too bad. Who's next? Ah yes, my distastefully named Oddish. His stats are, something. His moves are, not helpful, considering status conditions aren't really gonna work on Whitney. Her Miltank has a Lumberry. And to top it off, this thing doesn't evolve till level 21, which makes it also very useless. If you've got a sharp eye, you might have noticed at the bottom of my streams, I have a layout where all the gym badges and their level caps are listed. If anything's over level 19, we can't use it. And thus concludes the scouting report. This looks bad, but we still have encounters left that I haven't gotten. So let's take a look at those, shall we? First up, Route 35. Look at this, this looks perfect. We've got Nidoran. I know that has Double Kick. That'd be great for this gym. Let's see what we get on. Whatever. Route 36 is a bit of a problem. It's being guarded by this psychic trainer and this bug trainer. And since Oddish gets eaten alive by both of those like a garden salad, and it's our only eligible Pokemon left, if it dies, the run is over. I can't take that risk. So instead, we'll go to the national park for our last encounter. It's a Sunkern. and 6 balls later, that seed is mine.
Well, these two go together about as well as peanut butter and coal tar.
And so those are our final two champions, Sunkern and Oddish. This really isn't any better than before. It's like sending two children to fight a tank. But just look at me. Look how proud I am of my baby boys.
I mean, anyway, I slice this. There's just not that much of a chance of me winning. I don't see a way for me to win without some insane miracle ass pull.
I'm too tired to think about this anymore. Or anything. Too depressed. Who knows? Maybe if I sleep this off, I'll have some crazy dream sequence. And I'll figure out the answer just like that. Or not. Sunkern. And Sunflora. They evolve with a sunstone. That's the first prize for winning the bug contest, which takes place on Tuesdays and Thursdays in the park. Sunflora can probably take out the whole gym with solar beams, so if we win the contest, we get the stone, and if we get the stone, we get Sunflora. Oh yeah, it's all coming together.
I gotta admit, I completely forgot about this, but it's pretty lucky that this happened right before a Tuesday. The bug contest is tomorrow, so I'll be waking up bright and early to try and get that sunstone. Equipped with my desperation, my charm, and my need to take a shower, I enter the bug contest.
Let's catch some bugs.
Now, Sunkern is my national park encounter, so anything I find here I'm not allowed to keep, but if it's in service of getting the sunstone, that's absolutely okay. I opt for Beedrill over Scyther or Pinsir because, well, Scyther still lives in my nightmares after...
Oh my god!
God, I hate bug types.
But I'm gonna be sleeping just fine tonight, honey, because our Beedrill, our juicy Beedrill, won us the bug contest, bringing in a total of 342 points. And lucky for me, none of these bug catchers actually know how to catch any bug-type Pokémon. So, we net ourselves the Sunstone. All we need is Sunny Day and our set will be complete. Now, where do you find Sunny Day? Let's turn to our best friend, the internet, for the answer, shall we? Oh, that's perfect! It's in Goldenrod. I can go pick it up before I go fight the gym. Let's see... Oh, we can't get that yet. But there was another one. Where was that one? It's in the Pokewalker, and I'm playing on an emulator.
So that's it then? So all that was for nothing, because the one item that I still need is locked behind something I can't even get because I'm playing this on an emulator. And this sucks. I'm gonna have to reset. But what if I didn't? What if there was a way for me to transfer my emulator save data into something that can be read by a DS cartridge, take that save file and the cartridge, put it in a DS, take a Pokemon out, put it in the Pokewalker, go on a little expedition, take that Pokemon back with Sunny Day, turn it back into an emulation file, and put it back on my computer. Oh yeah, it's all coming together. Again.
We're not out of this one just yet. This might be a long shot, but in theory it should be possible, right? I don't know how to do it myself though, so I'll need to find someone who's technically savvy. And I think I know just who to ask.
Hey, can I get your help with something? Can you change my emulator file into a DS cartridge? I lost to Whitney in a Nuzlocke and now I need to go get Sunny Day. Oh, I have $5 and a bag of Cheez-Its, but I ate one of the Cheez-Its because I was hungry.
And we're back in the game. Always remember, kids, money solves about 3/4 of all your problems. I'm not going to show you exactly what they did because since I'm paying for it, I'm not exactly sure how legal this is.
Hey, is any of this legal?
Do you care?
You bet I don't.
You're gonna get $5.
Yeah!
I have to be careful. I don't want to draw the ire of any of those sneaky Nintendo ninjas. They could be anywhere at any time.
Hey, what are you doing in here, spying on me? I saw that little trailer you put out. That's not a finished game. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, go get out of here. Shoot.
While I'm getting all my files transferred over, let's go over what we have to do when we get the Pokéwalker. First, I have to unlock the Blue Lake, which is where I can get Sunny Day. It requires me to get 2,000 watts, and once I get there, I just have to take 5,000 steps and use the dowsing machine. Pretty simple, right? That'll account for about 45,000 steps in total. But we should put that number in perspective. What exactly is 45,000 steps? How far is that? How can we figure that out? Well, we go back to the internet, of course. Here, I'll just type everything into this nifty calculator. Put in my height. We'll just assume the average speed, the amount of steps we're gonna take. And let's see how far we have to walk.
Well, we've got a lot of work to do, don't we?
The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
Thinking. I can't run 26 miles in 3 days. I'm built like a fucking green bean. What am I gonna do?
Remember, John. Remember.
What is that? Who is that? Beyond the trees, beyond the clouds.
I have always been here, John. It is me, Travis Scott.
Oh, I always knew this day would come. I knew you would be there for me in my time of need.
Just as the sun will rise on any day, I am always here to watch over and guide my children.
Travis Scott, I'm at my wit's end. I can't push my body any further. I'm at my limit. I have to do this. Please, please tell me what to do. Show me the way. Show me the light.
You must look inside yourself. Look at who you have become. Would you really lay down your life just for a silly video? Please do not answer that. All change comes from within. You must take your place in the circle of life, John. You are my son, and the one true king.
Don't you give me that Mufasa bullshit. Just tell me what I gotta do, please.
Well, how can you expect a sunny day if your mind is clouded? Goodbye, John Keaton.
He's right. I hope to bring about a sunny day when sweat drips down my cheeks and onto my cheeks like soft rain. If I want sun, I have to make my own sun.
Yeah.
scratcher works pretty well, but it keeps heating up too fast. And I've already destroyed one of the batteries. It's time for an upgrade. That's it. Only took about 4 days, but the last of our preparations are done. We fight Whitney tomorrow. Actually, it's today. We're fighting her later today. All right. The day's here, and the moment is upon us. Will I fell the foul female, or will I have wasted 80 hours of my life? Let's find out. At this point, we're winning this, or we're losing this, with some flora.
If you don't play around the grid, your Nuzlocke team will look like shit. Wu-Tang.
All right, madam. Our first battle proved what a fool I really was, and I promise I will never disrespect women ever again. Hi, I'm Whitney. Oh, I know you are. I know. All right, this is what it all comes down to. Turn one, substitute.
Hey, listen up, y'all. I'm y'all substitute teacher.
The things you say just might be true. It could be time to start anew and maybe change my point of view.
Nah, I say let it die. Let it die, let it die.
Let's pause and be thankful for a moment. If I was dumb enough not to bring Substitute into this fight, that would have ended this entire run. Papa bless. There it is. Alright, now we're going to start taking an eighth of our health each turn because of solar power. But with our setups, our sunny day, and our sunflower power, this fight should be over. Now comes the scary part. Will our flower power go well or turn sour? 18 health.
Whatever happens on this next turn, thank you for watching this far and going on this journey with me. Without further ado, take it away, George.
It could last forever.
Yeah. Yes, me!
my chair over. Oh, excuse me for my bad manners, but... I did it, Mom. I won. We finally did it. We slayed the beast, and now I can move on with my life. It feels like I haven't slept in so long. Hey, Sunflora, how are you feeling after the big win?
Sunflora, 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 Sunflora.
Shut your whore mouth, Sunflora. Don't forget, I own you.
Sunflora, 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 Flora, Sun.
You're what? How could you do that? She killed all my friends.
Sunflora, Sunflora.
Well, that takes care of that. I still have no idea how I'm gonna beat Morty. My team kinda sucks, and his ghost Pokemon wall every option I have, but if you've learned anything from today, it's that I'm not gonna go down without a fight. So tune into my streams if you wanna see how the adventure continues. Ah, so many friends lost, so many of their names that I don't remember. Until next time.
Wait, couldn't I have just bought a Dratini?